Yeah, welcome to the next series in my online tutorial. Today, I want to briefly explain how you can schedule tasks using EDF. EDF stands for Earlier Deadline First. Put it in EDF. EDF stands for Earlier Deadline First. So we just want to see an example of how you can schedule a task using EDF. We'll look at that in a moment. So let us see an example of a task. Let's say we have this task. Is our task. Then we have we have these task. You're welcome to my next tutorial. Today we shall be discussing the EDF algorithm. EDF stands for Earlier Deadline First, and it's one of the algorithms that is used in scheduling real-time system tasks. So I have here a simple example. I have three tasks, task A, B, C. I have the run time of task A, B, and C. The run time is also the execution time. I have the period for 8:16, and I have the deadline. For more information about what runtime is, you could check text. It's just the duration of time for which the task to complete its job, the maximum amount of time that the job requires to complete the job. The period is the inter-release time interval. The inter-release time interval between jobs. And the deadline is the maximum time required for the job to complete, to run to completion. So basically we expect every task to complete on or before the deadline. Tasks are not supposed to exceed their deadline. So for example, task A, if it starts at time 0, is expected to finish at time 8. If task A starts at time 5, then we expect it to finish at time 13. So also the others. If task A starts at time 5, it means that it needs 2 units of time, so it can start from time 5 and finish at time 7, or it can start at time 6 and finish at time 8, or it can start at time 10 and finish at time 12. Because the deadline is time 13 if it starts at time 5, so time 8 can at most start at time 11 so that it can finish exactly at time 13. Anything beyond that will cause task A to miss its deadline. Just an overview. Like I said, you can check the text for more information about this these parameters. But today we just want to quickly see, using this example, how to schedule the deadline first, earlier deadline first. So I'm going to draw a line using this. So I draw a line. This is my line, my line. So let me increase the front of the line. So I can draw a line. I'm trying to get the line drawn. Okay, so I have the line there. So now let's try to run this to see how this task will be scheduled between 0 and try and get that right. And I mean, let's see how the task is scheduled between 0. So this is a 0. Let's see that between time. The text box. Box. So this is time is 0, and the maximum period we have here is 16. So from 0 to 16. So we're going to draw a demarcation. So this is 8. This is 8. And this is 4. And this is 4 plus 8, so this will be 12. So this is 0, this is 4, this is 8, this is 12, and this is 16. Because we have 16 here as a maximum period. So now, because we are not given the release time of the task, so it is assumed that all the tasks are released at the same time. So this is our task. So it is assumed that all the tasks are released at the same time. So here we have 3 tasks released here. So at time 0, we have 3 tasks that are released here. So we have task A is released here. We have task B is released here. We have attack. C is also released here. So what does earlier deadline for says? It says that which of these three tags has the earliest deadline. So as you can see here, tag C has to complete by 4 and tag B has to complete by 6 time unit. Tag A has to complete by 8 time unit. So because of that, the tax that has the earliest deadline, the notion of the earliest is the urgent that needs to quickly complete before a deadline, before it misses its deadline. So the concept, we want to ensure that none of these tasks miss their deadline. So we look for the one that its deadline is quickly approaching. Just like if you have series of assignment, and then today is Monday, you have one that is due tomorrow, Tuesday, and you have another one due on Sunday. So you quickly want to take care of the one that is due tomorrow, Tuesday, before you undo the one that is due later on Sunday, in a few days. So that's the same concept we use here. So because tag C has deadline of 4, so tag C will be scheduled here. So tag C will be scheduled first, then followed by tag 6, followed by tag B, and followed by tag A. But before we start scheduling them, we need to look at the release time of the different tags. So tag A will be a new job of tax A will be released at time 4. So we want to indicate that here. So at time 4, we're going to have tax A. Let's call it the second job of tax A, and let's call it A2. Now at time 8, the second job of tax B will be released, so let's call that B2. Now, and at time 16, the second job of tax C will be released. And since we are ending at time 16, we don't have to capture that, so we can just leave that out. So this is the second job of tax B. So now we'll go back to our earliest deadline. So the earliest deadline first is visible when the tags are preemptive and is running on one processor. You can read more about that in the text. So here, tag C will be scheduled first, and tag C is going to start running. I want to use a different color to represent that. So let me use this color to represent tag C. So tag C is going to start running from here, and it's going to finish here. So this is tag C. Now, when tag C has finished running to completion, because tag C is our high and tax A is low in priority, and syntax B is medium. So this is priority assignment based on earlier deadline first. So we have assigned task C and task C run for full time unit. So when task C has finished running to completion at time 4, so we can check and see that task C is able to meet its deadline, because the deadline is time 4, so task C is able to complete, run to completion on or before a deadline, which is good, which is what we want to do, ensure. Now, at this point, we need to go back and look at what we have left. So at time 4, we have task A, the first job of task A left, we have the first job of task B left, and in addition, we have the second job of task A now ready to run. So at time 4, we have again 3 tasks. So we have A1, B1, and A2. So we're going to look at between these 3 tasks, which one has the earliest deadline first. So if we check A, the original A is supposed to finish by time 8. Okay, so from here that it is released, we count time 8. So you have to finish here. Now, the new released A is released as time 4, and it has to finish now a deadline of 8. So 8 plus 4, 12. So it still has some time. So because of that, the first task A has higher priority compared to the second task A. Now let's look at task B. Task B has been released since 0, and it has a deadline of 6. So which means that task B has to finish by time 6, which is around here. So let me use a different color to explain that. So let's use this for task B. So because task B has to finish at time C, and original A, the first A, has to finish at time A, so that means task B has a higher priority compared to task A1. So because of that, we are going to schedule task B. So task B now runs for 2 time units, so it will run from 4 to 6. So once task B has finished running, then we also have to check again how many jobs we have and look at their deadline again. So we make that decision each time that a job runs to completion. So what do we have left? We have A1 and A2 left. So of course, A1 has to finish by time 8. So we schedule A1, let's use another color for that. So we schedule A1 from 6, and it finished at 8. So this is time 8. So this is our A. So when we get to this place, we look at the jobs that we have left. So we have task A2 left, and now we have task B2 also released. So remember we said that task A2 has to finish by 8 plus 4, because it's released at 4, so it has to finish by 12. So this is 12. A2 has to finish by 12, and B2 B2 has to finish by is released as time 8, and B2 has to finish in deadline of 6, so we have 6 to 8, which is time 14. So because of that, A2 has a higher priority because it has to finish by 12. Okay, so we will schedule A2, so back to our yellow. Okay, so we schedule A2 now. So A2 will now run from time 8 as a run time of 2 time units, so it will run to time 10. So this is 10. So A2 will run from here, time 8 to time 10. Okay, so that's our A2. So then what do we have left? Once I got here, remember we make decision again. What do we have left? We have only B2 left. So B2 will run for 2 time units, and it will run from time 10 to time 12. So B2 will run from time 10 to, so this is B2 running. So do we have any job left? No. We have A is done, B is done, C is done, and we have A2 is done, B2 is done. So this is a Gantt chart. Is a Gantt chart for the earliest deadline first for scheduling this task, these 3 tasks using the earliest deadline first. I hope this will clarify this. So in finally, we just do a quick check and make sure that none of our tasks miss their deadline. So we look at task A, is supposed to finish at time 8. So where's task A? So it's finishing exactly at time 8. Okay, then we look at time task B is supposed to finish at time 6. So we look at task B is finishing on the dot of 6. We're okay. Then we look at task C is supposed to finish at time 4. So it's finishing. We made a mistake here. This should actually stop here. Should stop here. So this should be time 3 because the run time of our C is 3, not 4. So we can actually, since we're just explaining, we can change this to, let's just change this to 4 so that so we change this to 4 so that we'll be able to match what we're saying, so that we'll not have to edit stop again. So how do I get back? So that is how that is. You can give it a try and check from the previous one what has it done. So, where is this? So thank you very much. You can give it a try and you see how this actually works. So please, if this you're able to understand this and you like this, please just click a like and give us comments so that we can keep improving on our side. Thank you and see you in our next tutorial.